Welcome to my tutorial of Trojan for the arcade. And this is another very old Capcom game. It's actually pretty good, but it's super easy for a Capcom arcade game of the time. I beat it in about 47 minutes my first time through the PlayStation 2 compilation version from the Capcom Classics Collection on PS2. And then after beating it on that compilation, I then moved over to MAME, and I beat it this version in maybe 26 minutes or somewhere around there. So it's very, very easy for a Capcom arcade game. Or just an old arcade game in general. You know, most arcade games are very, very fucking hard, especially ones from the 80s, early 80s, mid-80s. But, so one strategy I found that really fucking exploits the game is I'm using a rapid-fire controller here, and I have the sword button set to rapid-fire most of the time. And you press up to jump, which is very awkward in these kind of games, but that's just how the controls are. But if you press up and diagonal in a direction, you know, you will jump to that direction. So what I'm doing is I'm constantly jumping to the right, basically, and holding down the rapid fire with the sword. So I'm constantly striking. And I pretty much hold that the entire time. Now, while I'm holding it, I can't really walk. So jumping is pretty much necessary because it slows down your walking to a crawl pretty much. So sometimes I will shut the rapid fire off for certain parts because I find that it causes too much of an issue with slow movement to be holding it the whole time. So it does vary. But if you don't have rapid fire, just keep mashing the sword button while jumping and you can mow through a lot of enemies that way. So I'm going to be using that a lot and exploiting the game. For this boss, basically, you have to hit him from the proper distance to connect, and it's got to be around his head-shoulder area. And once you do hit him, you want to jump away because he's going to roll back into a ball as soon as you hit him. So if you don't get the right distance in the right range and hit him exactly a certain way, it won't connect. But you'll know it connects when you see a red splash near his shoulder and head area. And whenever he rolls into a ball, you just want to jump over it and just wait until he stands back up, and then that's your chance to try to hit him again. But you have to get the distance right, that's all. It's not too hard. But you do have to get the distance right. You may want to take off rapid fire for that part because it may slow your movement down. You know, it may kind of mess you up. But again, here I am jumping and striking rapidly with rapid fire and just, you know, blazing through the areas. And you do get checkpoints and unlimited continues. So you get to start from whatever checkpoint you got to. So you can take risks. You know, you don't have to play super carefully. When you're playing at home, you have infinite continues. So for this guy, you see, I just do the same jumping and mashing the button type of shit. And it'll take out his projectiles that he throws at you too, if you're lucky. And eventually you'll get in enough hits to take him out by doing that sloppy method. So, very easy way to kill that boss. There shouldn't be much challenge with that. And that's the way I'm going to be playing through most of this shit. So I thought it'd be kind of worth, you know, explaining a little bit and presenting, since it's a short game, easy tutorial to bang out. So you do have to jump on these platforms a lot of times to make them go down. If you don't land on them with a jump, a lot of times they don't go down. It's very awkward. So if the platform isn't going down for you, then just jump again, and it should make it go back down. So for this boss, just jump toward him. As soon as you land, just duck and just keep striking rapidly. And most of the time that will take him out. Now the way I edited this is I'm showing the first death on each new checkpoint that I get to. And the rest of the deaths are edited out. So that way you can see all the transitions clearly and where all the checkpoints are. Now, I may have beaten some areas where I didn't have to use a checkpoint because I just kept going. And in that case, you won't see the checkpoint. But in the most, you know, for the most part, this shows everything that's going on with the checkpoints. I do die on most of the checkpoints. But my goal is to rush to the next checkpoint and unlock the next checkpoint. So I'm not worried about taking some damage and shit like that. I'm just trying to beat the game. That's how I play most games. I'm always super aggressive for the most part. And, you know, usually find a lot of exploits in games. So for this guy, again, just jump towards him and just, you know, you see I died there, but just do that again. Jump towards him and just stay crouched down and keep mashing the button. And eventually that will be enough to take him out. You may have to do it a few times, but you'll get it. There's some luck involved with my sloppy method, but it's very, very fucking easy to beat the game like this. There are a few tricky parts, but really nothing too hard. And if you've played these old arcade games, you'll be surprised how easy this game is. So here you have to hit this open tab. Once you knock that in, start moving back. And you want to count how many enemies you take out, because it's always the same amount. So just memorize how many enemies to take out and then move over the mines. Once you move that tab, then you have to jump straight up on that area that says jump. And then you'll be on this guy. Now, for this guy, you want to use your shield. So try to block and then strike and try to counter that way if you can. If not, try to keep striking low, and that usually does have a chance at getting him. But if you don't block, he'll probably annihilate you. So you do want to alternate your shield with your strikes with that guy. And he can take some practice. You may want to use save and load states to practice that fight so that you know what to do on him, because he's tricky. These guys are extremely easy. Just jump towards him and just hit him low. You know, just do those low strikes again. And these low strikes even defeat the last boss. So it's a very, very powerful exploit in this game to use. Now, these jumping pads can be very finicky, and sometimes when you jump where it says jump, the trapdoor above you won't open. It's very fucking bizarre. And sometimes I have to jump several times to get them to opening, and you know, that'll get me killed. So I don't know how to do it always consistently. You know, you may have to jump around for a while before the trapdoor opens sometimes. So here we're going to skip another boss fight. See, we got this caterpillar boss again, but you can jump over him. You may need to strike him to get him to go back into a ball, but then just jump over him. And now when you get to this jump pad, start jumping, and hopefully the trapdoor will open for you. See, it was not opening right away. It's very weird. So this is a checkpoint up here, even if you die, I believe. So jump past the mines, and now this is the same boss we already fought. You know, often these games recycle bosses, and this is one of the early examples of a game that really does recycle a lot of bosses. So this is the same exact strategy of the last time you fought him. Just hit the projectiles and hit him and just keep mashing. And eventually, you know, moving side to side, you should eventually beat him pretty easily. So this is a very similar stage to the previous stage where we were descending down a tower with the trapdoors. Pretty much the same shit. So I just try to move fast. I don't try to spend time fighting the enemies. I try to jump onto those trap doors so that they open. Because when you land on them, that seems to be the trigger for them to open. But see, not always. They don't always seem to open. Maybe because I didn't jump on the center of that one. But see, I die here and now I get the checkpoint right next to these bosses. It's not far back. So take that guy out and then just drop down. And this is the same shit, just duck strike. And do it to both enemies. You can take them out very fast. And by this point, you're very far into the game, so there isn't much more left, but there's one tricky part where you have to fight two of the hardest bosses at once. That's the toughest part, probably, but, you know, it's really not that bad. But yeah, by jumping and striking, you know, you do exploit a lot of the game because it takes out a lot of shit that's in your way. See, those spiders get annihilated most of the time, and so do most of the enemies. Sometimes you may have to, you know, duck for a little while and do a few strikes. It's always better to strike while ducked because then enemies can't, you know, hit you up high. So for this, I'm probably going to die on this, and then you'll see me do it properly. So here's the checkpoint for these bosses. And you can get in there with no damage easily. And then once you get here, you want to take out the right one first. Try to alternate blocking again with striking low. And then I'm going to try to jump my way to this guy and get in range of him, get within a decent range, and then just go back to the same pattern again of trying to alternate your blocking with your striking. If you can block a strike and then immediately counter with a sword strike, sometimes that helps too. But as long as you stay crouched and alternate your shield with your strikes, you'll get him eventually even by luck. It's really not that hard. If you do it enough times, you'll eventually break through. Same boss again, so just going to strike low. You can ignore some of the enemies and just blaze through this shit. This is the final stage. So again, you can just keep blazing past this part. I believe we already skipped the boss, too, that was up on a balcony. You don't need to fight that guy at all. Now, once you get to this tower, you will be at the next checkpoint. It's the final checkpoint of the game. And this is the final boss. I died on him, but you see when I get back to him, if you do a ducking strike in just the right range, he won't be able to recover. See, I'll inch a little bit closer. You see he's blocking knee strikes, but watch when I get a little bit closer. It's a certain range. It seems like there's a certain range. See, it starts hitting his kneecap, and that seems to be the deadly range that he couldn't break out of it. Just all those strikes get in, and he just dies. So if you try it enough times, you should be able to get that, and it shouldn't give you too much trouble. And of course, after you beat the game does loop. It just starts over again, but you've officially beaten the game at this point. So yeah, it's an interesting game in that it has shield mechanics. You know, most games didn't have blocking and shit like that back then, so it is kind of an interesting mechanic, but you really don't need to use your shield. You know, you may want to use it on maybe that one boss that I mentioned, but aside from that, it's a very easy game to exploit. Let me know if you have any questions, and thanks for watching.